here like they did from every other prison?
I can't say, though they have indicated that they're comfortable here.
None of these documents make any reference to the prisoner's prior escape attempts. When might that be?
I do have that information, but I hope to explain in this more intimate setting.
Intimate?
Some of these details are of a more delicate nature. Exceptionally difficult to put on paper.
What kind of details
are... I'll start with inmate number 25.
Who's this?
Nationality, American. At first glance, his case looks like any other drug bust in the slums. But it became clear that he was unaware he was dealing with drugs. It was just a courier, and his sentence was lightened accordingly. And he was tested for symptoms of drug abuse, and found to have several food allergies, as well as what has yet to be identified as one or many illnesses.
Why would he choose to escape from reform school? You just said his sentence was light.
It's obvious the reform school doctors perform painful experimental treatments on the Sawyer, and the radiation related to the serious power in causing him to go berserk. He broke out in a blood rage.
He hates needles, and I gave him daily shots.
Really? What is he in kindergarten?
He was sent to prison after prison. Every time the day of his next treatment drew near, he smashed through the walls and ran off.
You don't actually mean that literally, right?
Fortunately, that's no longer a problem. Here at Namba Prison, we provide oral medication in a flavor the inmate is fond of. No injections necessary. He now looks forward to every treatment.
Okay, then. So that's why he no longer intends to escape. That would be hard to put on paper.
Next up, we have inmate number 69. He's an American as well. Was arrested and sent to juvenile hall after instigating an urban gang riot.
So this one's violent.
As with number 15, he has a clear motive for his escapes.
And what might that be?
He lost a threatening battle! Now he lives only to enact vengeance on the monsters who slaughtered his comrade! He broke out of there, he was sure that the killers face justice!
Actually, he ran away because the food at Chuvi was terrible.
Breathing is swell!
Continued escaping from every prison he was sent to because he found the meals intolerable. Here, though, he's become a model prisoner. He enjoys our food. Japanese cuisine suits him well. Shall I continue?
I see no point in stopping now.
Very well. Inmate number 11. Nationality, British. He was arrested and sent to juvenile hall after police captured him in an underground casino. He's both a talented and compulsive gambler. Despite my warnings and a confiscation of numerous decks of cards, it never stops. There's no money here, so they bet magazines.
So what's his deal then? Did he bust out because he was after higher stakes?
It isn't that. It would appear that his motive concerned a woman.
A woman?
I understand! He was only gambling because he needed the money! Money to pay the hospital bill for his wheelchair-bound girlfriend after her accident! He had to give her that cash through whatever means were necessary. Even if they break it out of prison!
I'm quite the imagination.
Why am I wrong?
Apparently he broke out of Judy because he had a hot date.
Why am I even surprised?
No matter what prison he was sent to, he would always escape on date nights.
Listen, you! You better not be about to tell me that he's behaving now because he has some kind of breakup.
That is not a bad theory.
No, I wish I had guessed it!
Perhaps I've overestimated these prisoners.
Finally, inmate number 15. He's native Japanese, sent to juvenile hall on charges of larceny, escaped on the day he arrived.
That quickly? How?
He has more arrests and escapes on his record than any of his cellmates. He is precisely the type of criminal who should be interned in this prison.
And have you found out his motive for escaping?
He says it's a hobby.
Huh? Hobby.
For the time being, I don't believe he has the desire to escape. If his temperament appears to change, I'll alert you.
Fair enough. You say there are no current problems. I'll take your word for it.
I appreciate your trust.